The main point of analyzing this circuit is to understand the fact that the current flowing through the collector of Q1 is independent from resistor RC and biasing of the transistor Q2. Because IC1 is only dependent on supply voltage at the emitter of Q1, the value of resistor RB1 at the base of the Q1, and also the value of the beta1, which is the current gain. So to find the voltage at the VO terminal, all we need to do is to calculate the current flowing through the base of Q2 and multiplying it to the value of the resistor RB2 and then summing it with 0.7 volt, which is the voltage at the base of Q2. To find the current IB2, we need to calculate the IC1, but this current depends on the IB1, which is the current flowing through the base of Q1. So let's write a KVL to determine IB1. Remember, Q1 is a PNP transistor, which its emitter should have a higher potential respect to the base. Now, by rearranging this equation, we will have and by plugging in the known values, we will get so the collector current will be 0.7 volt. Now by looking at the circuit, we can clearly see that the part of IC1 current will go to the base of Q2 and the rest to its collector. So we can write and again we can write the collector current in terms of the base current as follows. Now, IC1 is already found. We know beta2, so we can determine IB2. Now, as I mentioned at the beginning of the video, the output voltage, which is also the voltage at the collector of Q2, can be calculated as follows. We can accept this result because it shows the transistor Q2 is in active mode. An NPN transistor will be in active mode when the voltage at the collector emitter is greater than 0.2 volts. And here in this example, the emitter of Q2 is grounded. So VCE2 will be 6.3 volts. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. I have other videos in reviewing BJT transistor circuit, which I will put the playlist under the video description. Please push the notification bell if you would like to get notified when I publish new videos.